Today's episode is brought to you by Muscle Egg. Muscle Egg is 100% liquid egg whites that are uniquely flavored to satisfy your sweet tooth. I've been using Muscle Egg for years now, and honestly, it's the only way I can eat eggs. I'm a very picky eater, I know. Anyway, try the Muscle Egg for yourself. The link is in description below.
All right, so I just got back from my tanning appointment. Yes, I know. My body does not match my face. I didn't get my face tanned this time. But anyway, now it's time to go from this after. Woo! Here we go. Finished look. I'm ready. You ready, Anya?
I'm ready.
Let's do this.
It's show day, guys. What's up? It's show day. I'm super excited. Got my hair, my makeup all done. Now I'm just gonna pack just a little bit of posing. And yeah, I'm excited. Woo! Judging, and here's a few things that I like to bring with me. I like to bring my extra tan stuff in case I have a boo-boo, I pee down my leg or something, an extra pair of shoes. I'm bringing two pairs of shoes here, a water, some socks. Sometimes my feet get really cold. Oh yes, this is important, a resistance band. Some extra jogging pants. I guess I don't need those, but what the heck, sandals. And here I'm gonna put some of my makeup touch-up things in case like I have like anything to touch up, some powder, some extra face coloring, some lip gloss, and of course my hair products, along with my straightening iron, so that way my hair stays looking nice. As you can see, my hair right now is pinned up with this little thing, that way I can keep it out of my face and it keeps the little whoop-de, I don't even know what you call it, like a whoop-de-doo, like a whoop. But yeah, good news, guys. So far, no period. I was crossing my fingers and my fallopian tubes that my period wouldn't come. So far, it hasn't. So, uterus, you're doing good so far. Just hold off for like another, I don't know, 12 hours, and we're good. But yeah, I don't know. Before a show, there's so many things that go through my mind, but I try not to think so much about it. I try just to have fun and just think, you know what, I'm here, I'm having fun. And in a way, I kind of have to convince myself, like, it's not that serious, just have fun. And although it is serious, of course, I'm not just like, whatever. I guess my mindset needs to be like, you know what, just relax, okay? Have fun, display that energy on stage. But yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. I can't complain. I think I slept like 6.5 hours last night and did a little posing with Anya here, and she's doing a great job of calming my nerves, and she prayed to the glue gods last night, and I think it helped, so thanks, Anya. Yes, but let's see what happens. And oh, in case you guys didn't notice, like if you take a little look around the room, it might look a little familiar, and that's because we're in the same spot as the Olympia. So this was the Olympia host hotel, and Not the same venue, though. It's a different venue, but the venue here is more convenient because it's actually inside this hotel. It's just downstairs. But yeah, I'm really excited. First show of the year. Let's go.
It's almost time.
Yeah.
Where are we headed?
We're going backstage. Should be early.
Yes.
Unless they play a trick on us. Getting closer. Oh my god.
found her spot.
Yes, I claimed the corner here.
Right by mirror.
But I brought my makeup here, so at least I got that, you know? At least I got that. I even want to put on some soft soap because I'm feeling it's cold back here, so I'm feeling my toes will go numb if I don't do it. Yeah, some of the other things I brought with me. Gotta bring a mirror. Even if it's just one like this. Gotta make sure my hair looks good. You know, oh, baby wipes is another thing you must bring. Because you don't, because water is not your friend on show day, so you're gonna have to wipe like that, you know? Earphones to get in the zone. My favorite song for like motivation is All the Lights by Kanye West.
World-class pro bikini champion from Las Vegas, Nevada, Ashley Topwater.
Judging, and I'm not gonna lie, I am pretty disappointed in myself. Okay, I, in my opinion, had a pretty sloppy presentation, and I don't know if it was just the mix of nerves or what. I mean, my toes did go numb with the shoes, but man, the nerves got the best of me. Like the first show of the year, the nerves got the best of me. I felt so wobbly, I didn't even hit one of the poses I should have. It just felt so sloppy. But as far as the calls are concerned, ooh, I think I got like maybe, I don't know. So I'm a very realistic person, right? So in my mind, I'm thinking I got either third or fourth. I don't know. We'll see at finals. Unfortunately, I have to wait like a few hours for finals. But yeah, I might have got third or fourth. And it's like a little debate in my head. Like part of me is like bummed because I could have done a better presentation. Maybe if I would have done a better presentation, I would have did better with the call outs. And the second part of me is like, you know what? You gotta chill out. Just be grateful that you got to compete. You know, I think it's like, I always say like one of the disadvantages of being like successful or winning the Olympia for that matter is once you win, anything that isn't first is like a loss. Whereas like if you're a new pro and just competing amongst all of the girls, it's kind of like, you know, no one really expects you to do that well because you're new. You just kind of do it for the fun and you're excited about any placing that you get, even if it's like 10th place, right? And I think like for me, it's like, so since I've won many shows in the past, not that I expect to win them all, definitely not, but I guess I expect more from myself as far as like, I shouldn't be able to, you know, do a smooth presentation and all that. So yeah, it's just, and then other people, I guess too, it's like, that's sometimes I get in my own head too, where it's like I'm happy, but then I keep hearing like, "Oh, you didn't get first, that sucks."
then I'm like, well, I wasn't disappointed until you like made me feel disappointed, if that makes sense. So we'll see what happens at finals. Hopefully the goal is to clean up my presentation. It won't matter though, because usually all the judging's done pre-judging for bikini, usually, not all the time. But try to clean that up a little bit, at least, you know, try to work on that, and we'll see what happens at finals. But yeah, I don't know, guys. I might not get third. We'll see. But first show year, it's a good warm up, and you know, can't win them all. So, gassy pot. So here backstage, finals are happening soon, hopefully. And I'm starving. I'm not gonna lie, I didn't eat much today because I tried to wait for them all. And then there happens to be this cookie. But then I have to go on stage. So I can't. But I want it. But I can't. But you know what? I came this far. There's only a little bit longer to go. I don't think I'll give in this time. Or will I? Honestly, I just want to get this over with so I can eat. I'm not usually that hungry, but man, I'm hungry right now. Holy crap, I want a good like TGI Fridays or something. But probably just something like, here's the thing, I always work myself up like, oh yeah, I'm hungry, but then I'll just get a salad or something like that. We'll see. For finals, it's like more low key than prejudging. Like, you're not, because most of the judging stuff is in prejudging, so finals are like more fun. But usually there's more people in the crowd, but man, I'm like, okay, like, going on 7 something. I'm more of a morning person, so this is like,
and from Las Vegas, Nevada, Ashley Hulbosser.
Best thing to do is stay low. Box and J-Lo, we have many do what they know.
Because I won it. So I came back to defend my title and was unsuccessful. And it wasn't my best showing. It wasn't my worst either. So I didn't get the judges' feedback yet. There was quite a line, and I think they were trying to go to bed. God bless them. But I will get it sometime, maybe this weekend or next week. I have an idea of what they would tell me. Probably something along the lines of like, to try to become more balanced. I'm looking at my pictures and my videos and prejudging, and I think that my legs are really overpowering my top. It's an ongoing struggle, guys. I don't know. They need to match up a little bit better, for gosh sakes. But at least my glutes came in nicely. Definitely not, yeah, like I said, it's not my worst. I was really shaky in the closing for prejudging, but in finals I smoothed it out because I got to learn the stage a little more. But yeah, I mean, it is what it is. Gotta keep trucking through, and I think that's one of the hardest things about being like a bikini competitor. It's just so like up and down. One week it's good, one week it's bad, and a new set of judges, and you do different placing. Not to say I would place any better or worse in my next show, but it's just kind of like very volatile. It's anybody's game, really. But, you know, just reflecting back, it's like, I can't be too mad. I always say, no matter what happens from here on out, I can't be too mad. Because I've already exceeded all expectations I've ever had for myself in the sport. And I realize I'm very privileged to be in the position I am in. And I get to do what I love, and, you know, I don't think many people can see that. So at the same time, I get frustrated because I know there's things I can fix or things I could have done better at the show. But then the other half of me is like, shut up, Ashley. Like, look at the cool opportunities you have and all the cool things you get to do and all the cool memories you get to make and awesome people you get to meet. And a lot of people would just love to do what you're doing. It's their dream job. So I'm grateful for that. And, you know, we'll see what next show brings. Hopefully I can work on the shoulders and probably have to lay off the lifting on the lower body for a little bit. We'll see. We'll see what they have to say, but that's my suspicion. But I'll keep you guys updated. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm about to go out and have a meal with Anya. I don't know if we're going to order in or if we're going to go out to eat. We'll see.
Ashley, where are we?
I think we're in a restaurant. I see on the paper food, and it's going to come from the paper to here, to then my mouth and my stomach in a matter of 15 minutes. There is so much yes right now.
Oop! Oh! Wow. Okay. Thank you. We didn't get into the sugar factory. They didn't answer our calls. We weren't important enough for them to answer the call, so we're at Bonefish. And there smells like fish in here, but I see they have good stuff, so. Yeah, in the corner. Oh my god, it's still warm.
First bite.
Wow, so this is what a carb tastes like. I forgot what a carb tastes like.
Did you get your foods?
I got my food. Look at this. I'm already on a plate. And it's so beautiful. It's like art. I don't even want to eat it, you know? Trying to be good after the show, not going crazy, but this is so good.
So today we're having a photo shoot for my hamstrings, and my face might get in a few shots, unfortunately, but it's mostly just for my hamstrings, you know? So hopefully we don't know, but you know. So a lot of people wonder why I talk about my hamstrings so much and I brag about my hamstrings so much. And basically the truth is it's the only thing I have going for me. So I like to, you know, make myself feel better by talking about my hamstrings because I don't have a personality. My face is okay, but my hamstrings though. God bless.
Your right arm. There, a little bit less. You're right there. Good. 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 Perfect. Oh, that's good. That's good. And up. Lift up. Relax.
There we go. Look at that. All I need is for you to crop it from like. That's all I need from the photo. New profile photo right there. See that? That's new profile pic right there. Yep. Nice. Just. Cropping my face out because who cares? It's about the hamstring, yeah. That could feed a family of four. Like, okay, I guess. I just got to Pittsburgh and it's been rough. As you can see in my eyes, it's been a rough day. And I will tell you about it when I wake up and shower and get myself together. Because it is like 3 a.m. and it is way past my bedtime, and I'm so over it right now. To be continued. Good morning. It is 2 days post show. That means it's Monday. I'm here in Pittsburgh for my photo shoot with J.M. Mannion at the NBC News Online Gym. So I like to have a photo shoot with J.M. at least once a year, sometimes twice. But I definitely gotta go to this gym, and we are doing a Road to the Pittsburgh Pro Series. Yes, that's right, guys. That is a show that I will be competing in this month. So super excited about that. And yeah, this is gonna be super helpful because I'm able to get feedback today and see what I can improve on, see what I can fix. But backtracking a little bit from last night, you might be wondering why I had such a miserable time, why I look like complete dog poo-poo when I arrived. So I was supposed to arrive here in Pittsburgh at like 7 p.m. and my flight got delayed like 5 times. And I was stressing out and I didn't have any food. So I was eating like snacks from the Newport News, like little convenience stores they have in the airport. Which, honestly, it was so ridiculous because they didn't have any like real food, right? They didn't have any chicken salads or anything. It was like the only thing open in the airport. I was so mad. And not only that, it's like, not only did it get delayed so long, but getting an Uber out of the airport took forever because there's none available at like 3:30 a.m. And then even when I checked into this hotel, no one was at the front desk for like a half an hour. Even though I called and I was looking around, I don't know if this lady went on break or something, I don't know, but nobody's at the front desk. So that was super frustrating. And I was just so tired and cranky from the day that I broke down and I cried and it was super embarrassing, messed up my makeup. And I got here so late, or I guess you could say early in the morning, that I didn't even take a shower until like when I woke up today. And I slept with my makeup on, which can't be good for the skin, that's for sure. And just, yeah, I mean, but today's gonna be better. I'm really looking forward to the shoot. And yeah, let's see what he has to say. Oh, and by the way, guys, you competitors know what's up. The post-show tan, oh my goodness. Wait till you see my, I gotta show you my armpit, okay? Armpit shot. Ew, that's what a tan looks like. 2 days post-show. And I didn't want to like scrub it off yet because of this photo shoot today. But there is a product from Liquid Sunrays called Erase It that I can use. But once I do that, it's gonna take a few days to like scrub off still. But that definitely helps. But I was trying to keep as much color as I could for this shoot. But yeah, I'm really dry right now. Really itchy. I feel better though. But anyway, just had to show you that. The post-show armpit. All right, here we go. We're signing the contract. Pittsburgh Pro Show. Let's go. It's official. All right. Guess who I'm with?
Hello,
Mr.
everybody.
J.M. Mannion, the man, the myth, the legend. We are here at the MPC News Gym. And we're going to get a workout, film some stuff, and
find out why you're really here.
Exactly. That's what's up. Let's
right.
go.
Yeah, she's been in, well, you've been in this gym for years, whenever, especially when you lived right across the border.
2 hours away.
Yeah, that was it.
And I'm back.
So you're back. It's like your name should be like etched in here somewhere. Like, right? I think it should
yes,
be.
I would love that.
Yeah, we'll have to figure out where.
Maybe some graffiti in the bathroom or something.
No, we need it for people to see it. There's a lot of white walls here, so we can figure out something like Ash was here.
Yeah, okay, I like it, I like it.
Sound good?
Here is the famous NPC gym. Wow. Hey everybody, it is Tuesday and we are, let's see, 3 days post-show. And as you guys know, I went to Pittsburgh to film for the MPC News Online Road to Pittsburgh Pro Series. And yeah, that was super exciting. I always visit there at least once a year to get some content, to do interviews, and to get like feedback from judges. As you know, JM's son is Tyler, who was judging last week's show. So I got to chat with him about feedback. I didn't stay after the show because I was like, you know what, I'm gonna be in Pittsburgh the next day anyway, so I might as well just get feedback there. And it worked out perfectly because I get to have a conversation. I learned a lot. So I'm not gonna lie, guys, I already kind of knew this was what it was, but kind of hearing it was just, my heart dropped because I'm mad at myself. I am mad at myself because I should know better. Listen. My posing presentation and the individuals for prejudging was the worst I've ever done, and I don't know why. I, like, for some reason, I stepped on stage and had, like, a mental block. I had, like, deer in headlights. I was not able to calm my nerves. It was bad. And it's kind of, like, embarrassing because I know better. Like,
that's not how I do it during practice. That's not what I learned. Like, I can't explain it. So for this season, I tried to add in a whole bunch of new, like, transitions and poses to make it longer because my presentation is pretty short. And in return, I don't know if it was just because it was a new thing for me or just because it was the first show year or just because, I don't know. But I just did so bad. It was so choppy, so sloppy. Yeah, but when they said it, I was just like, oh, Jesus. Kind of like a stupid mistake, you know? Like, how could I do that? I can't explain it. Hopefully it doesn't happen again, but hopefully it's like a learning lesson, a blessing in disguise. I don't know. I just don't want that to ever happen again. And, you know, even diving in further, I was asking questions about, like, you know, the past presentations I've done and what they're looking for in a presentation. Do they want sexy? Do they want slow, sultry? You know, because I get that a lot. Like, Ashley, you need to be more sexy when you pose. And I always say back to them, I'm like, I think it's like you need to put your own personality into it, right? And I asked them, I was like, is that what you're looking for? Do you guys want, like, is it, like, preferable to be more sexy? Or, like, is it okay to be, like, bouncy? And he says, no, you can be bouncy, you can be fun, you don't have to be sexy. Just be yourself. And even went on to say, he's like, your presentations from last year, the year before, this hasn't really been an issue before. Even at the Olympia, they didn't say it was an issue. So it's perfectly fine. You can keep your presentation short, it doesn't have to be sexy, just make sure it's clean. And my presentations were not clean, and I'm pissed for it. And, you know, I think, with that being said, it was like, that was the best piece of advice. It doesn't have to be long. It doesn't. Like, just make it clean. Make it you. And I'm going to take that advice, and I'm probably going to go back to my old routine. Like, when I was doing it last year's Olympia and last season. He said himself, that hasn't been an issue before until this show. Although, a lot of people will say, oh, yeah, your presentation's too short. It's not sexy enough. Like, from the expert, he said, it doesn't have to be. Just be yourself, make it clean, make it smooth, you know? And I don't know, I think I just try to overcomplicate things. See, here's the thing. I know what to do. I know how to pose. I know how to pose people. And when I practice, I can even see my own flaws and what to fix. When it comes to being on stage and putting it into action, that's where it's like, I don't know, something happened, I don't know. But it scares me because I just don't want that to ever happen again. But you know something? I gotta stay positive. I'm gonna use this as motivation for next time. Hopefully don't make any stupid mistakes. Like I said, we're going back to drawing board, probably just going back to my old routine, maybe add a little something. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching and thank you for the support. I really appreciate it and I don't know. It's so cool to hear from you guys and get messages and comments from you guys. It motivates me sometimes to know that I can motivate you. Wow, look at that tan. Yikes. Yeah, my face doesn't match my body. That's post-show competition. Anyway, back to the outro. I appreciate you. What can I say? I appreciate you so much, and I hope to see you in a future vlog or whatnot. And yeah, I'll keep you guys posted on everything. You know, I'm going to be at Pittsburgh Pro. Huge show. So, whoo, definitely got to be practicing for that. And I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.